What would your friends say on a hot summer's day if you could open up a bottle of water and pour out an instant snow cone? In this project, we're exploring some tips, some tricks, and everything else you'll need to know to master the art of making instant ice. In a previous video, we turned water like this directly to ice in just an instant. For this project, you'll just need some purified water, and the easiest place to find that is in a water bottle. Go ahead and throw about 6 bottles in the freezer, because the more bottles you start with, the better chances you're going to have for success. The temperature dial in my freezer was set to 5 of 7, and that settled to a temperature of minus 24 degrees Celsius, or around minus 11 degrees Fahrenheit. Now these bottles have been sitting at room temperature overnight, and in my experience, this trick works best if they're evenly spaced and placed on their sides. The minute the door closes, make a note of the time. After an hour and a half, check your bottles to see if any of them have frozen. If they're all still liquid, then quickly close the door, but keep checking on them every 15 minutes. For these particular bottles, it took 2 hours and 45 minutes for the first one to freeze. Looking at the bottle, you can see it's not frozen solid, but you should see flakes of ice floating around under the plastic. At this point, stop and take note of the time. Then subtract 15 minutes, and now you have a super cooling formula for your favorite brand of water. In my case, this trick works from 2.5 hours to 2 hours and 45 minutes. Now, if the bottles in the freezer haven't frozen yet, take them out very gently. This water is well below freezing, but hasn't frozen yet because there aren't any impurities to get it started. The water does want to freeze, and that's why something as simple as a jolt to the side can be enough to nucleate the ice formation, and just like magic, you've got instant ice. You'll notice that bottles this cold will develop a layer of condensation, making it harder to see inside, so go ahead and wipe that off. This way, when you hit it, you'll have a much better view of the crystal formations. Another way to start your water freezing is to use a piece of ice. Put the ice anywhere you want, and then pour your water over top. You should see it freeze instantly and build quickly into instant ice sculptures like these. I put an ice cube on this rock, and you can see the crystals build every time the water makes contact with the ice. You could make this easier by using a whole bowl of ice. Now, if you start pouring your water and it doesn't look like it's building pillars very quickly, it means your water hasn't cooled enough and probably needs another 5 to 10 minutes in the freezer. This bottle did come out 10 minutes later, and you can see a dramatic difference in how quickly it freezes. If you leave your bottles in the freezer too long, they may be so sensitive that even wiping the side of the bottle initiates the freeze. And it could be complete before you even get the cap off. If you do get the cap off, pouring too slowly might result in this effect where the water doesn't pour out at all. And that's because it's iced up in the bottleneck and it's freezing the rest of the way down. If you're wondering how cold the water actually is, I was able to measure one bottle at minus 4.5 degrees Celsius. And there's a good chance they're actually colder than that. If you try pouring this super cooled liquid into a glass, you might notice it looks a little thick and syrupy. If you get to this point, try touching the surface gently with an ice cube. Everything freezes firm enough to hold the ice cube in place and makes a nice little platform to continue building your ice towers. When trying this approach, it's important that the glass is extremely clean, because even a microscopic impurity can trigger the nucleation and solidify your experiment prematurely. You could try using this effect to pour yourself an instant snow cone. As the water freezes, it actually releases latent heat in the reaction and warms the ice into a delicious slush. I tried using the juice in these freeze pops as a makeshift snow cone syrup and poured it on top to get 3 different flavors. Well, now you know everything you need to know about making instant ice. If you want to see colored crystals, try pouring 2 drops of food coloring in the water before you freeze it. Well, that's it for now. If you like this project, perhaps you'll like some of my others. Check them out at thekingofrandom.com.